All right, welcome back to round three with Black White Tokens on Modern Monday, and we're gonna play first. Five lands is rough, but this is basically like two cards, and I think Oryak Champion is pretty good against a ton of decks in this format. So we're gonna try to Oryak Champion some people. I'm gonna play this Godless Shrine first because theoretically we could actually survive off of getting basic lands with our fetches. Like, this deck is actually fine with just getting, like, planes, so. Scalding Tarnarino. Oh, why would you do that? We're just going to Oryak Champion here. I don't think there's a one-mana counterspell. And you cannot Lightning Bolt or Fatal Push this lady, this fine lass, so... I'm okay with the threat that this presents, so let's see if that, I do like that. Oh, is it Bitter Blossom? Let's Bitter Blossom Thoughtseize here. Interesting. I think it's just 100% Electromancer here. Yeah, that guy's gotta go. I'm just gonna get planes. Should have used Windswept Heath, but I don't think it actually matters here. So I like that Oryak Champion and Bitter Blossom cancel. Oh, I didn't even attack here because I was literally like, "Oh, let me hover over it and hit F6 while I was reading the card." Yeah, I don't need to get damage in. That's fine. It's only one damage anyway. What's that even gonna do in the long run? Nothing. So you play Island, so we know this is your hand. Always yield and always yes. It's actually pretty good. Let's dismiss all, get a new stack of six here. Let's see what happens. Grapeshot, gifts. Let's just get rid of the gifts ungiven. I feel like that's going to give you the most ridiculous, potential. Ridiculous potential. Is that what I'm looking for? All right, there you go. Got some lingerers out. Now we're going to attack. And they should be at 17. Alright, sleight of hand was what you drew. You played Island, sure. Storm count 1. Not being able to cheat on mana with something like Goblin Electromancer or Barrel is... pretty reasonable. So many lingering souls. It's actually pretty good for us. All right, so we missed 1 point is what we're looking at here, so. So if they win in one life, yep, and we are out of cards. I'm just gonna get a swamp here, gain 2 more, go to 19. 19's pretty healthy. So we know 4 of their 6 cards, 4 of their 5 cards. Here we go. Ritual. Manamorphose. Oh, look who it is. Past the flames is gone. Can they do 20 though? I mean, they could probably wipe our board, but they can't kill Oryak Champion, and they can't kill Bitter Blossom. So they're gonna have to do 20 here, and that seems ambitious. And we have to figure out how to split this gifts ungiven pile. So you know, that's the thing we got going for us. Our sideboard does have surgical extraction and a rest in peace. All right, what do we get? Click it to put it in the graveyard. We just want to give you the mana spells, I guess. Maybe? I don't want to give you Mana Morphos because it just gives you an extra card. But maybe we do? Maybe we give you Gifts and Mana Morphos because you actually don't net mana. Oh, Mana Morphos actually does give you a fourth mana, but then Gifts Ungiven only costs... Yeah, we're just going to get rid of Ritual and Ritual. I think this is correct. Hard to say. I have no idea. This deck is so complicated. All right, Storm Count is 10. We're at 20. Ooh. So now you have Gifts, so Mana Morphos is gone. Oh, Grape Shot's in your hand, though. Like, this costs 5 to flashback. I don't think that's going to cost less because it's not... Okay, so you're just Grape Shotting here. That's good to know. Oh, you're remanding your own Grape Shot. That's actually ridiculous. I'm impressed. And you cast it again? Sure. 2, 3, 1... Storm Count's 12. You recast Grape Shot again. That was amazing. I'm impressed. Dead, but impressed. Our 1 point did not matter. Yep, you got it. All right. Let's try again. Let's collect a Brutality. It's Grafdigger's Cage. Engaged on Making can come out. I don't think we need this many removal spells. Rest in Peace comes in. Surgical Extractions come in. Thoughtseize probably comes in. And what comes out? We need to take out 4 cards, probably a set of something. Probably the Paths. I think if we have 3 Fatal Pushes, that's just better than... Hmm. 2 other cards. I think Ariok Champion is actually very good. Take out 1 Sorin. And maybe we don't need 8 discard spells. We'll go down to 7. So I think we'll submit like this. I will play first. This hand actually seems fine. So we're going to get Godless Shrine here. It's going to be pretty rough going to 15. We don't have... Actually, we're just going to get Swamp. I think the 2 life is more relevant than the potential that we draw a... Yeah, sure. Than the potential that we happen to draw a Spectral Procession. Alright, so Steam Vent is gone. And Virtue. We can also play other Virtue and then just pretty much blanks their Pyroclasm, which is nice. Spire Bluff Canal, alright, so that's good. Actually going to play Lingering Souls here, and if they want a Pyroclasm, that's fine. They're probably going to wait to get more value out of it. And if they do that, next turn we can Intangible Virtue and potentially flashback Lingering Souls if we get another land, so... Nope. Okay, they didn't want to get greedy. I can respect that. Land? Grafdigger's Cage. That's pretty good. Should have played the Lingering Souls first. I don't know why we didn't do that. That was actually... I just got so excited about Grafdigger's Cage that I sequenced incorrectly, so please do as I say, not as I do. That is not the best. That was not the correct sequencing. I'm sure you guys are going to be like, whoa, you're the worst, but it's actually, that's not a play skill error. That's a technical, mechanical error based on... Magic Online. We knew what we wanted to do. We just did it incorrectly in the client, so. Also, if you draw a land, we're just going to play Sorin and make a 4-4, which is pretty good. They played Scalding Tarn. So we have two of their five cards. They could also be just running the Empty the Warrens version. Land. That's actually fine. I mean, even if this was a Plains, we still beat short, but I'm okay with having 2/3/3s. And if they ever want to kill the Grafdigger's Cage, then we have the Lingering Souls, but Gifts Ungiven, sure. You can have Pyroclasm. I don't want you to have Gifts Ungiven number 2 or Desperate Ritual because it's just strictly better than Pyretic Ritual. So you can actually have those two. What did we give you? We gave you Pyroclasm and the Pyretic Ritual. So we know 4 of your 7 cards? Sure. Land? I mean, these are actually fine. Get 3/3s. This almost kills them next turn. 13. So even like Empty the Warrens is not great here, but it depends on how many guys they can. Oh, that was pretty good. Let's crack this. Get Plains. We could also just play Spectral here, but I'm just going to Sorin and try to kill them. Also getting 16 is not nothing. Does that do it? Alright, sweet. So, despite not casting Lingering Souls first, which we might have even wanted to do, because, I mean, like, I'm not defending the misclick. Obviously, our default play was play Lingering Souls, play Grafdigger's Cage. But if they did have Pyroclasm in hand, it does play around that, which is nice. So, I think we're just going to submit like this. Sorin might actually be better than Gideon. In fact, I'm gonna go on a limb and say yes, just because of the lifelink. I think this hand is great. Turn 1 Inquisition, turn 2 Bitter Blossom, or Oriok Champion is very good. And Vault of the Archangel is a little awkward, but good God, the Shrine. And we'll see what you got. Barrel or Electromancer? Don't care about Ritual or Past in Flames. I think Barrel's actually better against us. The problem is Barrel's legendary, so stranding you with multiple Barrels in hand is one thing. Yep. Goblin Electromancer. Pretty sure we just play Oriok Champion here. Reason being, it blocks Electromancer very well, and the 2 life is relevant. Alright, so this is where we die, right? Ritual, which is literally just Dark Ritual when they have Goblin Electromancer here. So in your hand is Past in Flames and Scalding Tarn. Madcap Experiment. Well, that's going in the graveyard. So what is your hand right now? Scalding Tarn, Past in Flames? This is actually very scary because you have Ritual in hand. We're actually going to... Or you have Past in Flames in hand. We're just going to put both the Rituals in the graveyard. So we know this is your... Sure. Oh, you net a mana from that. God, I always... So now you have 3 mana. You can pass them flames, but you can't actually play anything else. You can... Actually, you can... Yeah, sure. Figured it was Platinum Empyrean. Yep. Okay, so your hand is now... Scalding Tarn, Passed in Flames, something else that you drew off of Metamorphose, I presume. Should have kept the Path to Exile in, I think. That's what my head's telling me right now. However, I mean, we definitely have a lot of time here, so... We can cast this. Next turn we can cast Entangled Ritual and Bitter Blossom or Sorin. Always yes, always yield. Not going to run this into Platinum Empyrean. But their life total can't change, which is awkward. Yep, we're going to block because our life total can change. Thankfully, this guy does not have Trample. But Vault of the Archangel makes it so attacking is pretty ridiculous. Yeah, we're just going to vault here. Tangible Virtue. And Bitter Blossom. Alright. Should I attack here? Probably not. Okay. Rough. Like, they can actually... The awkward thing is they can just sit behind Platinum Empyrean and we could, have no way to deal with that. I think they just win here anyway because they literally get a 2-mana discount off of everything they cast, so... I guess we should have kept Path to Exile in, but giving them a land... when we kill either Goblin Electromancer or Barrel is kind of like still giving them one use out of that card, and it's just Madcap Experiment was not a card we were planning on. It's very interesting. I'm actually surprised to see that inclusion, but it's pretty good. Now they have 8 mana and they're Gifsing. Storm count is already 7. Pretty sure we're just dead here. Like, as long as they have a Remand and a Grape Shot here, we're just basically dead, right? Because they cast this with Flashback, which I think is still 5. So they can literally go Grape Shot, Remand, 2 rituals, right? Okay, well, I'm just going to... None of this is ideal. Yep. Pretty sure we can have 6 here, actually. We have no responses because we have no mana and no instants, so. Well, I felt good about this game. We can actually get Sorin to ultimate as a way to win. And let me guess you... Oh, they can just actually pass in flames and then recast it for 1? Yeah, we're just dead. Just straight dead. So decks that deal infinite red damage to our faces are basically our weakness, it seems. So, why are you casting these? I'm tapped out. Just kill me. Alright, cool. Alright, we'll see you guys in round 4.